This is how we protect ourselves. This is how the average person protects themselves against inflation, is by acting ahead of the inflation that's coming. Hello, YouTubers, Alaska Prepper here. Ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be the first of two videos that I put out today. This video is going to cover how even Costco is joining the inflation bandwagon. And in my opinion, they don't have a choice. In order for them to stay in business, they have to pass down the cost of this, what the Fed likes to call transitory inflation, which we all know is not transitory at all. Ladies and gentlemen, there are ways that we can protect ourselves about this. And I'm going to explain to you on the second video that I put out today what we can do. The reason I'm doing a second video is in order not to make this one too long, right? I feel that it's much more digestible when I put out a shorter video, especially warning of people of things such as this, which I feel is very important because it allows us to prepare for what's coming. But the second video has to do with an experience that I had while I was in the military, and I'll leave it at that. From the Business Insider, your next Costco run could be more expensive as the company warns of expected price hikes for key goods, including trash bags, cheese, plastic plates, and beef. And I would say that anything that has plastic on it, anything that's packaged in plastic on it, will become more expensive because we are having problems sourcing those things that we make plastic with. However, how long will this last? Well, ladies and gentlemen, with taxes going up for corporations, in addition for ourselves, because whenever taxes go up for corporations, they'll go up for us as well. Corporations are not going to absorb all of that extra cost. They're going to continue to go up. I'm going to show you here a few items that are key items that are predicted to go up in addition to what Costco is talking about here. So let's go ahead and see what Costco has to say. On the company's Thursday earning call, CFO Richard Galanti says that inflation pressures abound, which means that prices could rise. And when they say could, it means they will rise for meat, cheese, plastic goods, and paper products. Mr. Galanti rattled through a number of inflationary soundbites with analysts on the call and shared a number of products experiencing spiking prices, as well as the reason for rising costs. He said that items shipped across the ocean, and we all know that we're having to pay more for container ships shipping things, have seen suppliers paying up to double for containers and shipping. Cheese in particular are curdling customers' wallets, in part due to freight costs and the strengthening of foreign currencies. What does that mean, ladies and gentlemen, the strengthening of foreign currencies? It means that the US dollar is weakening. Now, on the Alaska Prepper News channel, I go through the markets every day, and I also go through the Dixie, which is the metric by which the dollar is measured against other fiat currencies from about five other countries or so around the world. You see, ladies and gentlemen, it's a double whammy for the US dollar when it goes down. Let me explain to you why. When the US dollar goes down against these other countries, it doesn't mean that it's just going down against these other countries, because all of these other countries are also printing record amounts of dollars. But it also means that it goes down comparatively more so for the things that we buy. For them to only go down against other countries just means that those things that we import is going to cost more. However, when you measure the strength of the dollar against something that's real, it's going down a lot farther. So if you take a look at the Dixie, like you see right here, you'll see that it shows that the Dixie's only going down a little bit in the last month or so, what, maybe 1% or something like that? But have the prices of our goods gone up 1%? No, they've gone up multiple percentage points. That's because when people just look at the strength of the dollar as compared to other nations' currencies, they're not really looking at the whole thing. They're only looking at half of it. You have to take the dollar and compare it to something real. And as you all know, I like to compare the strength of the dollar to that of gold, because gold never changes in value. 1 ounce of gold is 1 ounce of gold. And if you take and see how much the dollar has been devalued since 1913, the year of its creation, and compared to gold, the dollar against gold has been devalued by almost 99%, like 98 point something percent, 0.999%. So although the dollar is being devalued against other currencies, which makes it more expensive for us to import things, it's being devalued even further against the real things that exist in our world, the finite things that exist in our world, the things that we need to live. And he continues to say that for mid-single digit cost increases for metals and aluminum foil could have a bad aftertaste for shoppers seeking sodas and other canned beverages. And some people think that I'm hoarding because I have two or three rolls of aluminum foil. See, ladies and gentlemen, get those things that you need now before the prices go up. They're warning you. They're pretty much telling you, hey, the prices are going to go up. So get your money out of the bank if you have some. I'm not a financial advisor. Don't go mortgaging your house to buy aluminum foil, okay? But get your money out of the bank. Go buy some aluminum foil if you need it. Why? Because you know that it's going to go up in price. In all actuality, I have to go out into town today. Guess where I'm going to stop? I'm going to stop at Costco. You know what I'm going to get? I'm going to get another roll of aluminum foil. You know why? Because I know for a fact that I'm going to use it. And I know for a fact they're telling us right now that it's going to go up in price. And he goes on to explain here that a post-health crisis wardrobe refresh could also be more expensive. And what he's saying is that after this health crisis situation settles and people go back to normal life, they're going to start to consume more. It's like some energy that's being held, right? People's ability to spend has been dwindled over the last year, year and a half because of what's been going on. So once they're let loose, they're going to spend more because there's going to be more people going to work, more people consuming things that they normally used to consume pre-health crisis, and now they're going to go ahead and start consuming it, and probably more so than prior to the health crisis. He said that certain apparel items are up 3 to 10%. Computer chips, oils, and chemical supplies could see spikes thanks to product shortages. Paper products could also cut into budgets as rising pulp prices send prices surging 4 to 8%. Meat is increasingly expensive, rising 7% year over year. Carnivores could get hit with a 20% surge for certain beef products in the last month, according to Galante. And in addition to that, ladies and gentlemen, if you saw the video where I did that Costco haul slash price check and I purchased the organic beef, ground beef they had there, I forgot to tell you how awesome that beef is. And I do believe that going forward that I'm going to purchase that ground beef. So guess what I'm going to purchase when I go to Costco today as well to get some of that tin foil. I'll be picking up a few more packs of that ground beef. Why? Because it's good. And why? Because I know it's going to continue to go up in price. They're telling us right here. They're telling us, ladies and gentlemen, protect yourselves and take some of that money that's going to be dwindling in purchasing power in the bank and spend it on real stuff. This is how we protect ourselves. This is how the average person protects themselves against inflation, is by acting ahead of the inflation that's coming. Sure, have we seen some inflation? Absolutely. But what we've seen thus far, in my opinion, is nothing compared to what's coming. Not everyone can go out there and buy an ounce of gold or 100 ounces of silver or platinum or any of that stuff. But ladies and gentlemen, I believe that everyone can go out there and buy an extra 10 pounds of rice or a 50-pound bag of rice, which is about the price of 1 ounce of silver. What would you rather have if rice doubled in price tomorrow? An ounce of silver or some rice that you know you're going to eat, that you know your family can consume? In my opinion, I'd rather have the rice. Do I like precious metals? Absolutely. But in my opinion, ladies and gentlemen, precious metals and vehicles that store your wealth and your purchasing power are best suited for those that have excess wealth, meaning that they have a full pantry of everything they eat for a full year. Of course, there are some things that you cannot store that you eat for a full year, like vegetables, you know, lettuce, things like that. But you catch my drift. Get those things that you know you're going to consume for the next year. and put it in your pantry, put it under your bed, put it in a closet. Don't make any excuses, because as those dollars dwindle in your banking account, the prices of foods are going to be shooting straight up. And here it says 7 grocery items about to get more expensive. I'm going to go ahead and go over that with you real quick as soon as we finish this here. And he continues to say that, quote, some of this is due to feed and labor and transportation costs, as well as restocking. Some of the additional increased demand is coming now from institutional needs as restaurants start to open. And we talked about that, ladies and gentlemen. Galanti also listed out other general inflationary pressures, including higher labor costs, higher freight costs, higher transportation demands, container shortages, port delays, and an increased demand for specific product categories. And anyone looking to take out the trash during spring cleanup is also out of luck. Galanti said that price increases for plastic and resin could see a price uptick for trash bags and plastic wraps, cups and plates. I'm very happy that I'm reading this article, because it reminds me that I need to get some of my big construction bags, because I'm only down to a couple of packs, and I know that I go through at least one pack every year while I'm doing construction around the property. So that's another thing that's going to be on my list, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you're getting something out of this article as well. The Costco CFO said that in the company's previous earnings call, he said his best guess was that inflation was running in the 1 to 1.5% range. That's since gone up. And we all know, ladies and gentlemen, that it's gone up higher than that. As of today, we guess that overall price inflation at the selling level and excluding our gasoline sales would be estimated to probably be more than 2.5 to 3.5% range. Galanti said some items are up more. For some items, the sell price haven't yet changed. Some items are even down a little bit. Galanti added, we think we've done pretty well in terms of controlling that as best we can, but the inflation pressures abound. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the time. I've been talking about this for so long that I almost feel like a parrot myself. But I need to continue to put out this message, because I'm not trying to scare you. I am trying to motivate you to go out there and stock up. It's just like Ray Dalio said, cash is trash. Buy stuff. Buy it now. I mean, if we have someone watching this video from Argentina or from Venezuela, please email me if you're willing to come onto our channel so that we can do an interview, so that we can ask you firsthand what your experiences are and have been in a hyperinflationary environment. Ladies and gentlemen, let me go over 7 items that are about to go up in prices as being told by these supermarkets, which are pork, bacon and hot dogs, beef, alcohol, toilet paper, fresh fruit, which makes a lot of sense with the heat and the drought that is currently happening in the west part of our nation and in other nations as well, like Brazil. Eggs, fats and oils. This is the time to prep, ladies and gentlemen. Like I said, I'm gonna have another video coming out later on today, because I'm going to explain to you why it is that there is no averting this situation. Prices will continue to go up, and there is no averting it. There is no magic wand that will occur. And the reason I'm telling you that, like I said, is from firsthand experience, from the mouth of someone that actually worked in the budgeting department in the Pentagon. That's going to be it for this one, ladies and gentlemen. I hope that you all had a very good Memorial Day yesterday, and I hope that you remembered the reason for the season, I guess, as they call it. Remember to be good to each other. When good people do good things happen. Remember to reach one, teach one, and repeat. If we all did this, the world would be a better place, and you know that it will be a better place. Many blessings to all of you and your families. I'm Alaska Prepper. I am out.